Hi there. Welcome to this brand new edition of Needlepoint TV on our brand new day. It's great to be here with you this afternoon. I'm Ellen Johnson. I'm the owner of Serendipity Needleworks and the founder of the Stitchers Club, and I'm happy to be here with you today. So we're going to chat just a little bit this afternoon about using straight stitches on your needlepoint canvases to add texture and depth and dimension and all those kinds of good things. So if you haven't already read the blog post that I posted on the Serendipity Needleworks website, I would highly encourage you to do that just as soon as we pop off here, because that'll make all of the things that we're going to be talking about make a lot more sense. So it is, just like I said, a delight to be here with you. This is our very first broadcast on YouTube, in addition to our Facebook page. And it's our very first time to be together here on Tuesday. Typically, we meet on Thursdays, but we've backed up our weekly broadcast to Tuesdays, and I hope that you're going to like the new schedule. If you haven't had a chance to check your email yet today, you'll probably want to do that too, because the weekly emails are starting to go out on Tuesdays as well. So you'll be able to have that information on Tuesdays, and then of course join me here on Tuesday afternoons. So it's great to see all of you here with me. I see we've got Susan and Linda and another Susan. We have two Susans and Renee. So it's great to be here with all of you again. There are going to be some things that are a little bit new and different since I'm going to be broadcasting here from YouTube or onto YouTube and our Facebook page. So y'all bear with me this afternoon as I'm learning some new things. And if you have questions, of course, please post your questions in the comments box. And as always, if you're watching this as a recording, please tell me where you're watching from. It's always great fun for me to see that as well. And I do try to come back and answer questions as people post those. I'll try and get to the questions as they pop up. But if I happen to miss something, I'll scroll back through before we wrap things up and see if I can't get those answered for you before we sign off here. So again, thank you ever so much for being here with me this afternoon. So one of the things that I wanted to make sure that I did was share with you a little bit about it was last week's blog post. So that's going to be something that's a little bit different. The blog post will be posted on Thursdays, and then we'll chat about that on the following Tuesday. So this blog post is all about using straight stitches on your needlepoint canvases. And when I say straight stitches, the best way to go about explaining what I mean when I say straight stitches is that stitches are assigned to different families. So there are a variety of different families. The way that I'm classifying stitches in this particular series of blog posts that I'm writing are straight stitches, slanted stitches, crossed stitches, looped stitches, and knotted stitches. So what I would dearly, dearly love to know from you, let me get back over here so I can see the comments. I'm going to make sure that, yep, okay, so we're good. We are good, good, good. Okay, so like I said, if you have a question, please make sure that you post that into the comments box, and I'll be more than happy to help. So today we're talking about straight stitches. Straight stitches are those that are worked either vertically or horizontally. They're not worked at an angle. And your straight stitches include things like the upright gobelin stitch. Some people say gobelin, but it's actually gobelin. And then there is the brick stitch, which is another straight stitch. We'll hop over in just a second, take a peek at the diagrams for these so you can get a better idea about what I'm talking about. But in addition to that, we'll also be talking about the Hungarian stitch, and then also the Florentine stitch, which some people consider, it's very much similar to Bargello, or actually it is Bargello. The Florentine stitch is a variation of Bargello work. Some people call the Florentine stitch Bargello, but there are other Bargello patterns or Florentine patterns. Those words are often used interchangeably. So, let's see. I don't have any questions at this point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to share my screen. So y'all hang tight with me just a second, and I will see just how that goes. If Here we go. All right. So I'm going to, here we go, y'all. Fingers crossed. I'm going to share my screen and I'm going to go to here. And I believe that that worked. So you should be able to see my blog post over on the Serendipity Needleworks website. And this is where we're going to, well, first of all, let me just say this. This is the the needlepoint canvas that I'm talking about in the blog post. And this is a design by, oh shucks, I can't remember her name, but Colors of Praise Designs. And so what I did in this particular blog post was walk you through how to identify the different design components, which in this case, in looking at this particular canvas, you can see that you have sand, water, sky, clouds, the beach cabana, the beach ball and the umbrella, the shadow on the sand of the house, and or the cabana, and then the colorful stripes on the back side. This is a glasses case. This is an eyeglasses case. And so this particular canvas, if I were going to stitch this piece as a using the decorative stitches, let me hop back on camera again so I can see y'all. All right. So if I were going to stitch that canvas as using the decorative stitches that I suggested that I was going to use in that blog post, I wouldn't finish that piece as a glasses case. I would finish it as a stand-up, maybe for a sideboard or a mantle or just somewhere like on an occasional table, just something that's not going to get a lot of use. Because anytime you use fancy stitches, decorative stitches, whatever you want to call them, they do have somewhat of a tendency to not be as durable as just standard tent stitch or basket weave. Tent stitch is the stitch that's just the little slanted stitch that you use on needlepoint canvases. It's the workhorse stitch of needlepoint. Some people call it basket weave. Basket weave is actually the manner in which it's stitched. It's another word or another name for the diagonal tent stitch. And it's called that because when you flip it over on the back side, that's sort of a nickname for it. When you flip it over on the back side, it looks like a basket. So that's really, if you're going to be stitching something that is a wearable or something that you're going to be using a lot, then I would recommend sticking with just the standard tent stitch. Whether you choose to work it in the continental variation, which is back and forth in horizontal rows or up and down in vertical rows, or the diagonal version of tent stitch, which is also called basket weave. So Sally has a question here. She says, can you do encroaching gobelin as a sort of diagonal? What you can do with encroaching gobelin is you can work it. There is a stitch called the slanted encroaching gobelin. I'll be honest, I've never tried to work the encroaching gobelin on the diagonal. I've always worked it in horizontal rows. That's a question that I would have to play around with and get the answer to that by doing some testing to see. But I've never done it. I've never seen it done. So my gut response is going to be, you know, give it a try if you want to, but I don't know how successful you're going to be with it. I like to do, there is, again, like I said, a slanted encroaching gobelin stitch, and that stitch is actually exactly like it sounds. It's slanted. So instead of being upright, which is what we're talking about today, the straight stitches, the stitches that run either straight up and down or straight east to west or side to side. And those stitches, they're worked, when you think about it, when you work a straight stitch on a canvas, you're working it either, again, straight up and down between two canvas threads, because you know you bring your needle up in a hole and then you take it back down over a certain number of canvas threads back down into the canvas into a hole. And that particular stitch sits in the channel between two canvas threads on your needlepoint canvas. The same thing happens when you work it from east to west or left to right. It's going to sit between two canvas threads on your needlepoint canvas instead of going across canvas intersections. So what you'll find happening when you work a stitch that's either a true straight up and down, true vertical or true horizontal stitch, you're going to find that you're going to need more strands of thread to cover, to get full cover coverage on your canvas. So if you're typically working a, say maybe a size 13 canvas, 13 mesh canvas with silk and ivory, but you want to use straight stitches for a particular area, then what you're going to find that you're going to need to do is you're going to actually need to use a thicker thread if you want something, if you want full coverage on your canvas. The other option would be to use a stranded thread and just use additional strands of thread. And ironically, silk and ivory is made by Brown Paper Packages, and they have a sister thread to silk and ivory. And that thread is called Trio, and that's T-R-I-O. Trio is a strandable thread, divisible thread that you can use, and you can use however many strands of that divisible thread that you want in order to get the type of coverage that you're trying to get. So if you had a canvas, a 13 or 14 mesh canvas, and you wanted to use a thread, like I know one of the colors that they have in silk and ivory, they have one called Pansy. It's a really pretty purple. And if you wanted to, if you found the perfect match for your canvas, but you wanted to use in that thread, say Pansy, but you wanted to use a straight stitch and it wasn't going to give you full coverage and that's what you wanted, then an alternative would be to order Trio or to purchase. You don't necessarily have to order it, but to find a shop that carries Trio and then use the Trio, and you would use all three strands. And what you would do in that case is you would pull them apart, divide them, strand them, and then put them back together in the eye of your needle. And then you would use a laying tool to lay the strands on the surface of the canvas to give you the full coverage that you were trying to achieve. And I say three strands. I feel like it would probably take three doing straight stitches like brick stitch and Hungarian stitch and the Gobelin stitch and those others that we're talking about here. So, Janice, where is my blog? So let me share with y'all really quickly. The blog is there. That's the address. It's the website address. And if you go to serendipityneedleworks.com, then that'll take you straight to on the very first page of the website. You'll see at the very tippy top, it says using straight stitches on your, let me hop over here and look really quickly. Okay, using straight stitches on your needlepoint canvases. So let me show y'all just really quickly how to do that. Let me show you how to get there. So I'm going to go back over here. Let me share my screen. Buttons are in a different place than I'm used to them being, so y'all hang tight with me. All right, so I'm going to share my screen. And what we want to share is this. And this is the blog post. So when you go to the blog, to the website, you'll see the logo at the top. And then actually, if you go home, let me go to the home page. The article this week's is going to be the one that you see in this image right here. Last week's is, the most recent, because now we're doing things at a different sequence. So this is actually last week's because the date on it is August the 6th. But the previous one, the previous week's, which was July 30th, is the one that you'll see if you scroll down just a little bit. And they're in sequential order, chronological order, I guess. Sequential is order, but in chronological order. So to go to that blog post, just click on that. And then you can scroll down. Don't you just love that canvas from Susan Roberts Designs? That makes me want to go to the beach. I just love it. I think it's so cute. So we were talking about straight stitches, and stitch families. This is a really good intro to stitch families, and it gives you basic information about those stitch families that I was talking about, that I'm going to be chatting about over the course of the next few weeks, because we are going to be talking about different stitch families and different kinds of stitches that you can use to embellish your needlepoint canvases. So as we scroll on through, and I'm going to try not to go too fast because I don't want to make y'all dizzy, but you can see that on the blog post, there is a diagram for each of the stitches. So if you were looking for a diagram for the upright Gobelin stitch, you can see that it can be worked over multiple canvas threads, but it is truly a straight stitch. And you can see what I'm talking about when I say that the stitch is going to lay between or lie between. I get my verbs wrong. The stitch will lie between two canvas threads. And if you were to, I don't know if I have a horizontal iteration of this or not. Let me scroll up. No, I don't. I don't have a horizontal illustration, but you can see with the brick stitch, it's the same thing. The stitches actually lie in the channels between, or the valleys between, the canvas threads. Same thing is true with the Hungarian stitch. Love the Hungarian stitch. And if you get my weekly, let me hop back over here so I can see y'all again. So if you get, oh, wow, isn't that cool? Wow. All right. That's pretty fun. Now I can see y'all. Okay. This is great. So you can see that the Hungarian stitch, it can be worked vertically or horizontally, but, you know, I love this stitch for, actually, you can flip it on its side and use it for clouds. It makes a really, really pretty cloud stitch. It also makes a really, really pretty sunset sky stitch, especially if you're using an overdyed thread or a variegated thread or multicolor thread, whichever. I mean, they're all different kinds. They're all multicolored, but whether it depends on the way the dye is applied to the thread as to what the actual term is that you use to describe it. But it makes a really pretty sunrise sky too. All right. So let me see if we have any other questions. All right. I don't see any questions at this point. So what I'm going to, let me go back over here and see. I think I can hop back over here and let's see what happens when I do this. So there's the Florentine stitch. All right. Yay, it worked. Good deal. All right. So the Florentine stitch, you can see, is what a lot of people term Bargello, or use interchangeably as Bargello. So the Bargello is a really good stitch or type of stitch to use for things that show movement. So like water. This is a really good one for the water on that canvas that I shared with you at the very beginning of our time together here. So this would be a really good stitch for water. It would also be a really good stitch for sky, because it's a really good background stitch too. So the nice thing about this particular stitch is that once you get the pattern, and I guess this is true with a lot of the decorative stitches, but this one especially, once you get one row established, it is super easy to work the rest of the pattern. You don't even have to look at what at the chart or at the stitch diagram. Once you get the first row established, you can literally fly with this one. So I love, love, love this one. And this is also a really fun stitch to do on just blank canvas. If you have some thread and you want different colors of thread, maybe take different shades of red and do a color study. I know we had one member of the Stitchers Club who did this with a variety of different multicolored threads. She used Karen Collection watercolors and did a Bargello, a color study in Bargello using overdyed threads from Karen Collection, and beautiful. Did some hearts for the Hearts for Hospice project, and they really, really turned out lovely. So all kinds of fun uses for this particular stitch. So like I said, if you get the weekly emails, I also shared in today's email with you a couple of other uses that I used some of these stitches for on one of my projects. So if you're not signed up to get the weekly emails from Serendipity Needleworks or from me, make sure that you go over to the website and click the connect button, and that, or even on the homepage, there is in the sidebar, there's a place for you to sign up to get my weekly emails. And I always try and include a little something extra for all of my subscribers, and just as sort of a little thank you for being a loyal subscriber to the Serendipity Needleworks weekly emails, and to people who follow me here on now YouTube, on Needlepoint TV, and on our Facebook page. So, all right, let me pop in here and see if anybody else has any other questions. Let's see. So Janice says, so your blog is always in the top banner, so click on that. Yes, absolutely. So if you want to, and let me go back to the website so that you can see that. So if you want to get to the Serendipity Needleworks blog, the blog is always, the most recent article is always going to be in that picture, that long wide picture, or the wide picture across the page. That's the most recent blog post. And then up here, if you look, there are some drop downs. So if you click under Needlepoint, go just for beginners, that'll pull up the different blog posts that are specifically or have been specifically designated for beginning needle pointers. And then I have other things like, oh gosh, for example, let's see, girlfriend getaways. Last year we had a retreat, and this is an article all about that. And then under inspiration, we had, I did a post earlier this year about the different shops around the country that were doing mail order when all the COVID stuff started. So this is an article there. So, but what you can do is you can just go across the top of the navigation bar and find things. You know, just click around. You can't break anything, so don't worry about that. Just click around and see what you can find, the fun things that you can find. And this is the connect button that I was talking about. So if you click on that, it takes you to this page. And what you can do is you can sign up for our weekly emails here. So that, my friend, is all about the, and I guess what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop. Wait a minute. Let me do this. Let me stop sharing my screen. Okay, there we go. So that is all about straight stitches. Again, I encourage you to go over to the website. You can see the website address in the banner down below. And when you're there, of course, if you haven't already signed up for our weekly emails, please make sure that you do that, because it's always fun to get new people on our list so we can share all of the wonderful goodness of needlepoint with you. The more the merrier. And then also we can keep you up to date on the latest from Serendipity Needleworks, things that happen inside of our Facebook community. We have a free Facebook community. So if you're on Facebook, we would love, love, love to have you join our Serendipity Needleworks circle of friends. The name of the Facebook group is, if you just go and search inside of Facebook using their search bar, just type Serendipity Needleworks and it should pop up. So we'd love to invite you to join us there too. Thank you ever so much for being here with me this afternoon. I appreciate it so, so much. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And until next time, happy stitching. Bye for now.